Hey everybody, it's Cthulhuigi. Sorry for the non-synchronous start of this compared to the end of the last episode. Had a bunch of technical and logistical issues, but we are good to go now. This is the shrine I was walking to at the end of the last part. Oh my gosh, So, I did do this shrine already, and I spent a bunch of time trying to figure out how to get over here, and then I remembered that I have, Oh wait, you can't use bird's bonus, in shrines, so it doesn't matter. Yeah, I guess bird's bonus would really trivialize shrines. Now I sort of understand why you can't use the stuff in here. Plus, like, the tests of strength would probably get messed up by, the other ones, which are all more combat-oriented. I'm not talking crap. So yeah, this shrine is pretty straightforward. What all did I cover already? I basically did a lot of rambling about how this is, the least time delay between parts, being recorded and uploaded since, like, the first part, because I'm recording this on Sunday and it'll probably go up on Monday. And I talked a little bit about how I might switch from 7 days a week to 5 days a week uploading these, so my parts go a little further, and just because I've been, like, I got, like, really bad food poisoning, and that took me out of commission for a few days, and it's just hard for me to find, good times to record. So, I hate dropping something with, like, a durability up in a special effect, but this one is a better version of it, basically. I probably could get rid of the Phrenic Bow, but I don't know. I'm always gonna have, like, infinite access to the pretty good bows that the Zelda amiibo gives you, so more or less a moot point, I think. So yeah, I also talked about I don't really know exactly what I'm gonna be doing in this part. I think I'm gonna, like, go to this shrine that I'm already in and already got to. You didn't miss anything exciting on the way over here. No Koroks or anything. Just, there's a Lynel. I really am not happy about my capture device, like, randomly disconnecting its USB, because that's been happening pretty consistently for the last three recording sessions, and it wasn't doing that originally, so I don't know if this thing is just on its, like, last legs, or if I did something that, like, bumped the USB, but, I mean, I haven't changed anything about my recording setup since the first several parts where I was able to do stuff with no issue. So, let's see. I guess if I go over to... Let's see. Okay. I didn't, like, completely process. That's the thing I just jumped over. Okay, so I'm back over here. So yeah, that's definitely something. That seems like it would be closest to the tower over here, which was my ostensible goal, but I actually feel like checking out this weird Thunder's Mountain area that I triggered earlier, and I believe I mentioned that, like, when I first went over to the area, it said, like, Thunder Steps if you tell all of the guardians to their ancient posts. You'll be healthy, wealthy, and wise. And it gave me a shrine quest, so presumably it's gonna be do stuff in the overworld, and you get a blessing shrine, because that's what shrine quests have typically been. This is the right area, isn't it? Yeah. What is that? It's a green thing that's, like, higher resolution. Or not high resolution, but visible from such a distance. I guess there's one way to find out. Do I have metal stuff? I definitely have metal stuff. Don't think the Guardian stuff counts. And, oh yeah, that was part of the reason. I don't know if the bird bows are metal. I guess one way to find out, and that way to find out is to equip one that I know isn't metal, so I don't risk getting blown up. And then when I start seeing lightning around me, check and see if in the inventory it's sparkling, showing it's metal. I really like these weird mushrooms trees. But yeah, other than, like, clearing... darn it. Clearing out... Oh, the green thing is probably the same as whatever this red thing over here is, which is something related to the puzzle. Yeah, it's probably like green, red, blue, yellow for the different things. And do I have enough stamina to just do this the way I'm not supposed to? Yeah! Okay, so this one is on lizard head, I guess. I'm assuming these are supposed to look like the guardians. Can I get up there? Is this magnetic or anything? Is it? No. Is this like a golfing minigame? That's what... That makes the most sense to me, actually. Dun, 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 dun. That seems like that should do it, right? That probably wasn't good enough, was it? Oh well. I wonder if that's the right idea! Oh yeah, I thought this was like a much deeper swamp for some reason. I think it was just the water effect. Can I like just sort of toss it up that ledge? I guess I'm gonna circle this and see if there's any like obvious way to do it. Okay, orange, not yellow. And I'm guessing that's supposed to be the camel. I think it has weird freaky teeth. Texture on this isn't so great. This isn't a very spherical sphere either. Run low on poly counts. Ugh, I thought this was supposed to be next gen. Ugh. Sometimes this is what you get for being a Nintendoran. Nintendoran. Okay, I can totally chuck it up there. Okay, I was worried that was gonna go really, really far. No. No! Link, you got no... You can't shoot any hoops. I do actually like these shrine quests a lot. Like, on one hand, knowing before you do them that they're gonna be a shrine is, like, a little lame, but the fact that, like, pretty much all of the important collectibles have been co-opted into the shrines means that, like, they're not really fooling anyone if they didn't tell you that if you're going to do a lot of work, so... Overall, I think they're more fun than the actual, shrine puzzles, on average, at least. Okay, like... On one hand, I'm pretty sure this isn't the way I'm supposed to do this at all, but on the other hand, like, I can actually tell this is gonna work if I get a good angle. And on the third hand... I wonder if using Gusty's Galaxy would blow this up too, although I don't have a good feeling about being able to, like, control where it goes. If that was true, I guess it's worth a try. Okay, no, never mind. It just doesn't even affect it. Is there, like... Okay, was this the green thing I could see? Probably. Looks like it's about right. I think I, like, couldn't see the pillar very well. So, yeah. Obviously, the puzzle is to get them up here. Oh, I thought that fox was a thing. Oh, that's pretty cool. Updraft? No. So yeah, the bird's already where it should be. Oh, and purple. Wow, I was like pretty off on my color predictions. I guess those will be the colors of the, well, no, they won't be the colors of the guardian abilities, because I know that one is blue. Did I, like... did not use my time up there wisely to scout out if there was a better place to try to bring it up. I'm gonna give this a couple more tries and then stop being totally stupid, because you missed out on, like, really quality me being stupid content in that shrine. I figure I'll give you a little something to laugh about. Okay. It's just that I really don't like walking while carrying this. I'm like around the back right now, so there's still like possibly somewhere on the side that would be a good place to bring it up. Is this like wet enough to do Cryonis on? And if so, okay. Alright, so if so, is there any point where I can do that? That's like close enough that that height boost matters is the question, because I doubt that I can do it on this rocky area, which is like the only area I can get up to the thing very easily. Yeah, no, it's just out there, so I was gonna say, it's probably sort of bad that I like really like to use Cryonis when it's like either sequence breaking or the stupidest way I could be doing things, but I like was like, oh, I thought this area was entirely flooded, and then I don't use Cryonis. Is there a way to get up there from here? Oh, is it like there's gonna be a metal crate that I put it in and then magnesis that? No, that doesn't look like it's magnesable. That was a waste of durability. I need to not be so precious with durability though, because honestly, I would like to have inventory spaces more than I would like to have a lot of good weapons to a pretty real extent. Okay, so I'm just gonna get really high up and see if I can scout out like a good place to do this. Also, because whenever I use the bird beak ability, I sort of want to use it all three times, so I have it recharging. Because what if I need to use all three in a very short period of time? Am I missing like something super obvious? I'm like getting really self-aware, not self-aware, self-conscious in this part for some reason. I think it's because I'm rusty real deal. Not played this in a while. I'm really not like sure if maybe I was just supposed to launch it up there with a with stasis. Yeah, actually that was like so close to working. I do feel a little stupid for not just putting that up somewhere else, like, because there was yeah, that's whatever. Yeah, and then because it's on a little bit of a ledge here, it should. What is going on over there? The Aurora. That's. Is that the. Oh. That's just the thing that I pinned, I guess. That wasn't actually a shrine, maybe. It was just that. Oh, yeah, and that's Satori Mountain, so I think that's like. Like in honor of Iwata, and you can get a weird Spirited Away goat horse up there. I might get that actually. Yeah, I'll check that out after this. That was presumably. I'm like, oh, it's really weird that that you have to do it on such a tricky angle because it's gonna roll away. And then I realized that instead of being dumb and bad, I should not. I wasn't. I don't know what you're talking about. I never had a metal object out. Okay, yeah, whatever. That was not complicated at all. God, this area reminds me the shit out of Xenoblade, though. Like, in Bionis Leg, where there's the weird mushroom platforms like this. Is it true that Monolith Soft like worked on this a lot, or is that like weird clickbait rumors? I think they probably did, but I don't remember a legitimate source, and I do know that there was like a dumb fake leak on 4chan talking about that. Let me not waste, well, not even not waste, just let me use this, so, because I don't know if the, bonus stamina, okay, I totally didn't need to do that, but at least I still have my half of a wheel. Let's just do this real quick with no complications. Gonna move it over here so I have a slightly better angle, and then immediately freeze it so it doesn't fall, although it looks like it was gonna be good about that anyway. So that one, I think that should be good for. I think if I did it all the way, I would risk launching it over the entire thing. Maybe that's crazy to say, but I think I'm fine. I did pull out the, yeah, Guardian Sword. I just want to make sure I didn't, like, space out and pull out another metal weapon. Okay, so let's see how tricky it's actually going to be to get these things up there. I didn't really think about how that was going to work. I kind of have a feeling that you throw it in the slot and it'll get sucked up or something. Oh, wait. So... oh, never mind. They weren't supposed to even be up there. They were just... that one was very easy to get. And then the purple one was also very easy to get. Easier, really, because you don't have to climb it. That lightning scared me. No, get in there. There you go. Hopefully this is a puzzle, it's not like something... I can't imagine it would be anything other than this. But the fact that they're not, like, clicking in... I say that's weird, except I think that's exactly how it worked for the one in the desert that I was also not great at. Okay, I wasn't sure if I was gonna be able to get over that whatsoever. Do I have any other stamina up? Not really. Oh, wait. Restores and overfuels. Okay, I should make a bunch of those. That is actually very good because I have a large regular stamina wheel. Not sure if there was another way I was supposed to get up. Ooh, these are slick and slimy with ice or with water, aren't they? I don't think this would be how it would work. Okay. If you could make Cryonis platforms, like, out from those to climb up, that would be kinda funny. Oh, it's a little hypocritical that, like, water is really slimy, but not, like, Cryonis thing, just platforms made out of literally ice are just easy to grab onto. I guess you could say the rune is also, like, an etching with handholds and stuff, but... that sounds awful to, like, barehandedly climb up magic ice. I guess the magic part might make it better. Okay, well, that was fun. Feels sort of stupid for not stasis golfing. Like, the thing is, I didn't not stasis golf from the get-go. I stasis golfed, realized that was clearly the intended solution, and then got really distracted trying to cheese it. Whatever, I like glowy objects. I wonder if those are, like, stuck there now, or if I could very labor-intensively take them to my house and have them as beautiful glowing trophies. I'm curious what it, where it would, like, even update those objects' position at all. So, what's the trick here? Lots of crumbly blocks. I don't want to crumble until I know what I'm doing, though. Can you climb up crumbly blocks? No. So I could just go up there, but it's not open yet, so that would be pointless. I have a feeling I'm going to have to start, like... blowing these up to see what's actually happening here. So, no sense delaying the inevitable. I'll leave the ones that are, like, obvious helpful platforms, though, I suppose. Oh, that's interesting. Those aren't, like, super sturdy. Can I, like, selectively... probably. Okay, they get destroyed when they fall. That's sort of cool. Alright, well there's part one of the puzzle. Oh, that's a heavy, heavy switch, too. Not even a... I thought that was, like, a big ball socket for some reason. So, is one of these metal? Is that gonna be the trick? I have, like, a pretty good intuition that that might be the trick. And then I also can use the metal one to climb up to that chest. Ow! This game can't surprise me. I'm a gaming champ. Can I bust these up with it? I don't really want to, because it's gonna make getting over there a little bit more annoying. Actually, I wonder if this has a fail state, because I guess this probably needs to stay on the switch. No, you can. There's totally just platforms. That wasn't much of a puzzle, although it just occurred to me that this is the thing I got for the shrine quest, and it's not a blessing, so that's actually sort of neat. Okay, and that chest was missable if I was not cautious, I think is the trick there. Whoops. Actually, it might not be missable. I think you just have to bring it up here. I don't think it needs to be on top of those, although I'm gonna see if I can gently put it on here. Yeah, okay. Well, that should absolutely work. Oh, except that I can't. Okay, never mind. The crumble blocks. Roost was a distraction, evidently. Why can't I climb? I don't understand what could possibly be affecting my ability to maneuver and jump off. Wait. Can you not jump off the ladder? That's weird. What? This is awkward. Do I even need to be up that high to do this? Oh, pfft. Once again, I'm like really good at overthinking these things. Get down from there. Get down from there. Get down from there. You're gonna fall. It's dangerous up there. It's dangerous to go alone. Take this. Yeah! That was a good puzzle. Yeah, overall, this is one of the better shrines. Like, I like that the shrine is kind of just a weird Wario Land 4 toxic landfill crunchy block smash catharsis puzzle, because it sort of had a tedious shrine quest build-up. But, like, after that tedious shrine quest, just a blessing would have, like, felt very rote, so I'm glad they didn't do that. I'm still curious how you would get up here if you... I guess you could just glide. I feel like there might be something else in here, but I'll just check the map after I leave. Probably not, actually. A true hero. A true hero. Yeah, I should be put at a nice 8 after cleaning up the stuff on my map, and then I can get my third stamina wheel, and then I can go back to upgrading hearts. I'm not really sure how many shrines I'm gonna be doing, though. I think I've rambled about this at length for a while. I'll probably get all the shrines. I don't know if I'm... I'll probably take a break after I beat, like, Ganon, and I'm planning on doing that within the next, Oh, boo, you can't pick these up anymore. Within the next, like, 10, 20 parts? Okay, yeah, there totally was other crap in there. I might even, like, if I'm really feeling bored, stream cleaning up those if I can get my stream set up decent, but that is a, more ambitious goal, to say the least. Oh, and there's a little friend right here, apparently, according to me, so... Oh wait, and that's a little friend that you would need, to glide from the tower to get to. Well, let's clean that up. Now, the real question is, do I want to go for 900 Korok seeds? Yeah, that's 61 total that I have, not 61 plus the ones I turned in. Like, it feels like the progress I've been making has slowed down. It's like, probably because there was a week where I was, like, recording for a couple hours a day every night, and then I didn't do it, and then the numbers that were correlated to me playing the game stopped going up as much. Am I gonna make this? Now I'm curious if I... Yeah, okay. Yeah, it's fine. I think this is actually... I originally just came over here because I wanted to see what was up with these weird trees, and, like, the second as I fell on this, it, triggered the, like, secret ancients text. Oh, wait, it was, like, this one all the way over here? Wait, what? No, very much not that. It was... That tall one? No. That tall one. No. Where are the, like, two overlapping ones anyway? Am I, like, having the dumb... I think I'm probably having the dumb. Oh, well, it was this. Oh, okay, that's why it was overlapping. It's weird because... In the three-dimensional plane, they weren't overlapping. I was looking for, like, two that were totally fused together. I mean, I wasn't really, but... Oh, just a bunch of friends. I think that... I've been using bomb arrows on these guys to get a lot of drops, but maybe this is more efficient. Okay, wait, can I just trick them into... crap. Yeah, that was pretty good. Gotta save up for all the treasures from the Monster Master. Although, I think you only get the wing from the flock. If you got the eyes now, imagine what a good deal that would be. Yeah, I did a good job fixing that circle. Bye-bye. So... Yep. Can get rid of that stamp. Get rid of this pin. And, Ceres Scablands. What does Scablands mean again? I need to get rid of that cream soup before I eat it by mistake. Well, if I see any Koroks over here, I'll get them. It doesn't look like there's too much going on in this area, though. Oh, what? Swift Violet. Okay, that's actually kind of nice. I've been using a lot of speed up just for jokes and enjoyment, although I'm like really paranoid of going close to the edges of these. Yeah, for good reason apparently, whatever. That guy's a bitey. I don't really care about materials right this moment. I want to go to that Aurora thing in case it stops being an Aurora thing at daytime. It's like a dry river here. It's sort of cool. Maybe that's what Scablands means, like a area that used to be forested, but then a bunch of weird mushroom trees took over. What is that? Oh, I know what is that. can't believe I correctly surmised there was going to be Koroks in this area. Like, it's always a gamble if there will be Koroks in an area or not. Hey, I'm curious. I guess I still, like, needed to talk to the elder and get the... Where's an axe-type weapon? Or I guess it's not that it has to be an axe. It has to be heavy, but yeah, I want to do this. Oh yeah, I found a new material type off-camera. It was Tabintha wheat instead of Hylian rice, and you get it the same way just by cutting tall grass. Can I find it again? Oh, well, there's a big man here, so that could be fun. Where was that Korok balloon? Just up there. Do I have a strong enough bow to hit that? Yep. That was a good one. Oh yeah, I need to remember to get that one that was like that with those big statues in the desert too. What are those? Okay, let's see how much cheating I can do. Hello. Whoops. I got Elephant's Love. I can play this stupid. Why was it not taking damage? Oh, because it had armor on that leg. Yeah, that was overkill probably, but... Ah, damn it! No! No! At this point, I'm just gonna solve them. It's against the rules. I'm cheating. Wait, what was that flower I was distracted of? Hyrule Herb. Okay, I guess I normally pick those up in more forested areas. Okay, so... with all distractions aside, it's time to go find a ghost horse. Did I actually... I think I got the monster bridle and saddle. Where does it put those? I don't even know. I guess I should heal up, but at this point I'm just... more interested in burning my Elephant's Love to get the free spirit hearts. Yeah, it looked like it's really well lit here. Yeah, what is going on? Why is sunrise at 3:25? Or is it blood moonrise? Or another thing? Yeah, it must be sunrise, but it's weird. I guess it's like almost 4 now. Well, in that case, I definitely want to get up here on my semi-baseless assumption that it only works at night. I wonder if there's like a shrine up here too. That's like a pretty... what's the word I'm looking for? Attractive beacony thing. It's beaconing me over there. Also, huh. That's weird. I guess it's supposed to be sort of hard to get to. Maybe I'm just going at it from the wrong side. Is that a Korok thing or just regular rubble? The master rapper. I think that's regular rubble. I should turn in some like Korok seeds, although like now I just don't even know what numbers I wanna wait for. Okay, there is evidently a shrine nearby. I should stop using my very strong battle axe. Let me just, yeah, I'm fine with beating this for some reason, despite it being the same rarity tier. Bloop, 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 bloop. I'm not gonna I, like, don't have any good ideas on where this is gonna be other than the top of the mountain, so that's where I'm going first. Although, it seems like my beepus would be telling me if that was the wrong way. You gotta listen to your beepus. You know what they say. Zelda always thinking with his beepus. This is a very bloomy area. Oh, lots of Narbits. I'm supposed to take a picture of these, aren't I? This is actually the right one. Camera. Zoom. Hooray! Some guy wanted that, right? Let me put on full sneak gear. Did I buy full sneak gear? No, I guess I just had sneak pants. Okay, let me eat full sneak snacks. And, then what? I'm just supposed to puncture them with arrows and they give delicious prizes? That seems sort of mean, but I think you, like, get a thing for doing it. Maybe if I do that, it'll scare the horse. I should just talk to the horse, probably. I don't want to be mean to these rabbits anyway, even if they are full of treasure. Hello, bird. Sooth. Do I have stamina? No, I ate all my stamina. Yeah. Do you just need to spam your full health bar on that, I guess? That seems like it would be a thing that would be easier to do if I actually had any idea how the horse mechanics worked in the first place. Well, that's a cool magic horse anyway. I'm guessing it will come back, and I didn't screw myself out of it permanently. Possibly when I, oh, yeah, okay. The horse is a lot less skittish than the bloopies themselves, I guess. Oh, I should probably take a picture of the horse and see what it's called. I hope it's just called, like, a Blorse or something stupid. Oh yeah, Lord of the Mountain, I think I remembered that. You are close! There we go. What does the Wikipedia have to say about him? Him or them. Oh, reincarnation of a sage that died. Oh. That's a little bit of a downer. I mean, that's sweet, but I don't like thinking about that. Oops. Why not? That would be really weird if I couldn't get up there. See, I didn't think that was the case. Oh, I'm not taking these birds' eggs. Oh, well, Bloopus is down there. I want to see what they give you from shooting them. If they look sad, I will apologize. In fact, I'll apologize so hard that I will reload the save if I feel bad about it. Or if I feel like it violates the spirit of the run. That was not the most exciting thing in the world. I don't feel mean or particularly compelled to do that again. Let me cut down these trees so I can actually see what's going on here. Would hate to miss out on, like, the 50 rupees or whatever. Oh, that was cool. I'm glad that there's a teleport up here. It'd be sort of annoying to climb that every time. So maybe this will be a cool and weird and hard shrine because it's in a cool and weird and hard to get area. Or maybe it'll be a shrine lots of great treasure because it's in a treasureful area. Oh, this is pretty good. I don't know about synced. What do they say? You gotta synced or swing. Let's get you sitting up here. I somehow didn't really think that was gonna work. Can I pull it under me? Whoops, that like worked for a second and then I just didn't follow through properly. Okay, having that hopefully reset is probably gonna be a boon in any way. No, it didn't reset, but whatever, I'm overthinking this pretty hard anyway. Okay, I'm like not very good at this apparently. Is it gonna keep the swinging? Because that would actually be sort of nice. Oh, it didn't even respawn me at the start. Well, that's very nice, Borat. Okay, that was like... I like sort of mentally buffered my inputs, expecting Link to like get up from the respawn faster or something. Incredible machines stuff going on here. Looks like it. This should be good, right? No, not really. I'm not like, it's not staying where I think it is going to. Okay, like right here. Oh. Yeah, I don't really know why I was, I guess, like, you probably couldn't originally grab it from this angle, and you gotta finagle it so it is grabbable from here. Okay, I was gonna find those eventually. I mean, I did, so... That was a weird way to put that anyway. No? Like, I'm sort of surprised there weren't any tricks over there. Ooh, that's pretty cool. I don't have too many spears. Goodbye. I mean, it would just be rude to reject a gift from the Koroks is the problem. What is preventing me from just doing like this? Oh, I guess, like, you have to be careful not to be stupid and put it in a place where it, hits you. Or maybe when you trigger that thing, it'll, like, fling these and you'll get hit if you don't have them swinging, or... I don't really know. Darn it. I actually, like, really want that. I'm having a little bit of trouble. I got a little disoriented. Okay. Oh, damn it, why can't I drop it? Where does it respawn me now? Okay. That's doable. I don't even know what I was going for right there. But it worked. Probably don't want it to be... Actually, it doesn't look like it'll hit me from here. So yeah, what's the trick with this? I don't know what the hell I was saying earlier about, like, the shrines never require arrows. Oh. That's not what I thought it was going to do. Um, Like, this game does know that I have arrows that can... This, like, doesn't even seem like I'm breaking the puzzle. It just seems very unlikely that you would need to do that, unless there's something I'm missing. Oh, and then that whole thing's a metal door. Okay, so now my only real question is how to get over there. Can I stand on this track? Oh, well, I can... Okay, I sort of thought it was gonna do something like that. Is that, like, just at an angle and it's gravity doing that, or what? Also, can I... Okay, I can walk onto it, and when I walk onto it, it'll fall. Because you no longer, are on top of... Or you are suddenly on top of the thing that you're not supposed to be able to manipulate if you're on top of. I am happy to say that I saw a video confirming that the nuts and bolts, I mean, it's really the Havoc physics engine, or just video game physics engine promise. Whoa! I guess that was the thematic reward for being in the bloopy area. But, yeah, what the hell am I prattling on about? You can, in fact, get inside a metal object on top of, or get inside a thing that can carry you on top of a metal object and fly around, which was the premier way to travel in Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts to Sequence Break. And I think that's relatively common in games with manipulable physics engines. I know, I'm almost positive it works in Cargo too, although saying that something works in Nuts and Bolts works in Cargo is not, like, too much of a revelation. Considering they're the exact same video game. Also, I sort of don't think the physics engine in Cargo works good enough that you can do it. I don't even know if you can magnesis things in that. I don't know why I was thinking that was the case. I think it's because I just don't have a distinct part of my brain for Cargo versus Nuts and Bolts. They occupy the same wonderful, open-ended physics machine puzzler. Video games. Hello, bird. I don't know if I have a picture of the humble crow yet, and the fact that this one doesn't think I exist means that I should get a good picture of it. Yeah, hooray. Can I just take a crow? I like that little dance he did. Okay, yeah, so I'll try and see if my good pal Bloopus wants to be my horse again if I actually come at him with a full stamina bar. Oh, free Gorok, nice. Oh, it was going to lead me to the shrine, and I spurned it by trying to shoot a little rabbit for no reason. I feel bad. Where? Okay, that was sort of obvious. I was, like, trying to figure out if the particle effects show you where it's going or not. Well, I'm glad I'm coming up on an hour and my capture device hasn't screwed up. So yeah, I'm gonna just check out the bloopy and then end the part. I'm tempted to keep recording and then do an awkward cut, but part of me just likes having a one video file be one part. Okay, so I guess he's probably either only there at night or only there when you're not being scary, or I just somehow found another pond, but I don't think that one's very likely. So let me get to the top of this mountain at least. Orient myself properly to figure out where I'm going for that last tower. I think I saw it in the distance earlier, but I want to be pointed straight at it, so it's a smooth sailing straight over there. So is that a secret Korra? No, those are secret bird eggs I already saw. So that's not the tower, is it? That's the Gerudo Tower. The tower I'm looking for should be somewhere around here. That's the plateau. Right, so I want to be looking this way. Yeah, it might be up there. I guess I'll go to Red Mountain, starring Knuckles, and see if I get a better look, better view from up there. Because it's probably in that vicinity. I don't know what that secret cloud is. I can't even tell if that's supposed to be a secret cloud or if it's a regular cloud. Probably a secret cloud. But, yep, that's where we're heading next time. Thanks for watching.
Game on.